Hey, it's time for XCOM again, part one. I recently did a attempt at this game, failed miserably, hopefully not gonna make the same mistakes this time. Well, we've upgraded to Longware 14E, and so it's a bit of an upgrade now. I've hopefully fixed my, there were some issues with the Russian's names file. I'll fucking tell you about the names file a little bit later. But anyways, we're playing XCOM Enemy Within with Longware mod. And it's, yeah, it's what it says. It's Longware, definitely. I know I did during my first LP, I explained a lot of the game when I was playing it. I'm gonna do a bit again. I'm gonna try not to be as, like, descriptive about it, but whatever. Anyways, we are playing on Brutal. I'm not good enough for Impossible. Probably not even good enough for Brutal, to be honest, but who gives a shit? Let's go. I did Operation Slingshot during my first LP, so we're not going to do it. We are still keeping on Operation Progeny here. Even though I kind of started it in my last run of this, I'm still going to keep it on because I still want to see the... I haven't actually seen it to the end. So there's going to be probably a couple of familiar missions. Because something about an alien abductee is more than what you seem. So that's it for these options, and also removing beginner VO because I'm assuming you guys have seen this game before. As for second wave options, we are putting on Not So Long War because this game is ridiculously long and is the only way I can see it being practical for me to put onto YouTube. And we're also putting on strict screening because the game by default doesn't randomize stats. The mod adds it in, and I'm just going to take it off again because I'm really lazy and I don't want to have to deal with like a rookie that has really low aim and mobility and HP and then have to like throw him away. It wouldn't be fair also to the wonderful people in the names file. So, I just cancelled everything I just did, so, fucking professional shit. Anyway, so yeah, I guess without further ado, XCOM, go.
Recent extraterrestrial incursion. This Council of Nations has convened to approve the activation of the XCOM project. You have been chosen to lead this initiative, to oversee our first and last line of defense. Your efforts will have considerable influence on this planet's future. We urge you to keep that in mind as you proceed. Good luck, Commander.
Earth, for the third time, is under attack. What the fuck, Earth? Anyways, up to YouTube, etc. to take control of Earth. You know what? You know what? No, we're going with a world domination strategy this time. You see, we wanted to control Earth, and the aliens are fucking trying to compete on our turf, so we gotta fuck up these aliens. So in Long War, the bonuses have changed somewhat for continent bonuses. Monthly bonus is still 30% for Africa. South Africa is power facilities are 60% of their cost. Future combat is all projects and foundry cost 60% of regular cost. Kind of okay. Labs, workshops, and officer training school projects cost 60% of the regular cost build and maintain. Good. Although workshops and labs are kind of nerfed from the first game, so don't count on those too much. Or aircraft and aircraft weapons cost 70% of the regular cost to purchase, build, and maintain. This is a really good bonus, because the air game in Long War is huge, but we're going to Europe because they have a strategy there.
France is sending an urgent mission request. We've picked up a local broadcast indicating alien activity within a major metropolitan area. We should get down there and eliminate any hostiles.
We're going on a tour in France. Alright, well, here we have the Sky Ranger. And we have a customs names file with now 400 fucking names. It's ridiculous. I had like two videos up, and by the way, you can't get into the file now. It's too bad. It's just whoever is in now. And so the rookies will be randomly named after people who watch my shit, so... wait, what?
Strike One, this is Central. You are free to engage all hostile contacts in the AO. Don't take any chances.
Okay, we got Lure Lug. Gale Storm. Mongo Bungo. Darwal. Rail Gun. And Haladin. Welcome to the team, guys. And we're probably gonna lose soldiers, lots of them, etc. And it's gonna go horribly wrong real fast, just trust me on that. So welcome to XCOM Long War. One of the first things I have to mention is, first of all, we have our little cool HP bars here. I think it's like, that one HP is added by our armor, and then we have four base HP, so that's kind of the color difference there. And also, you start with six squad mates instead of just four, like in vanilla XCOM. It's one of the things the mod does. And also, we also get random grenades and equipment at the start, so you're not completely fucked at the beginning. So this guy has a med pack. We have another med pack here. Two med packs. We have an AP grenade. Now, we also have... we don't know what the last thing is. We don't see armor on him, so it can either be a laser sight or an extra scope, an extra clip in his gun. And then we have another med pack and AP grenades. Lots of AP grenades. So without further ado, let's go get started. Let's go breach it out.
On Earth, we're witnessing something never before seen in recorded history.
Okay, so welcome to XCOM. The name of the game is Fuck This Noise. And let's see what's up here. We're gonna start heading up this building. We're gonna just dash up to the building. Basically, my plan is to basically go on top of the building here and get kind of a flank. One of my biggest mistakes in my last run of this game was I was far too aggressive. This is me playing not as aggressively. I'm overwatching and kind of playing it more safe. I'm planning on just going on top of the roof, and we can kind of see the aliens are just screwing around over there. So they're likely going to take some shots at us. He's also got full cover from the boxes over there. So there's a couple mechanics that are completely different in this game. I didn't expect him actually to get a shot from the window there. So we're probably going to want to actually move that lady over there. So we don't lose a rookie as our first thing. I think someone's coming from over there. I think what we're gonna do is we're all gonna run up to the second floor, and we're just gonna let him come to us.
Moving.
Okay. So this should work out pretty well. All right. So you see, like, if we go right now, we can kind of see. Oh, 20%, 20%, 35%. Oh, don't mind if I don't. We also have the option to steady your aim for a turn, which will increase the aim by 20 for the next turn, but we're not going to do that. We're gonna run the fuck away. That's what we're going to do. XCOM, flee.
10-4.
And then overwatch everyone else. And then my plan is during the next turn to basically move them over to the sides here to kind of see where they went. So I'm hoping that they'll kind of recklessly come up here. Maybe like use two of their moves instead of just one. Yeah, they're not going to be able to do much with me up here. So we're playing, yeah, more defensively. What the, where the hell is this guy? Alright. Don't know where this guy came from. Do they have a ladder? They must have a ladder over there. Okay. I mean, if that's all he did, that's actually pretty good. And so we smell Meld. Meld is a new mechanic oh yeah, there is a ladder there.
On my way.
Alright, so we can get the easiest flank of the world. Dural gets the first kill. Welcome to Earth, motherfucker.
Kill confirmed.
So this is actually, this here.
To self-destruct when the operator dies. We should look closely for any fragments that could be salvaged for our own development programs.
I thought we removed the beginner VO. Apparently not. Alright, so here's our plan. Our plan, whether you choose to accept it or not. Let's see.
Moving.
Let's see what's down here. Okay. I don't know if I want to really overwatch there. Oh, nice breach. Now, here's my options here. So we know that they're down here. We can actually see someone getting melded over, like, down at that corner. So my plan is this. I'm going to have two people kind of cover one side and two people cover another side. And then, I mean, this is... I didn't actually expect there to be two entryways. Actually, I probably should just block that ladder. And then they have to come up the stairs. You can actually do that. But we'll do that next turn if they don't come up. That unfortunately does mean I'll have to fight them from over here because they'll be able to see me. So let's have a look. Okay, this rookie's gonna go have a peek. Okay, we do not see anybody down here. But doing this basically means I'm free to cover the stairwell here as they come up.
Moving.
Let's get another one over here. And this last guy here can come onto this side. So I'm fairly certain that they can't come up the ladder now. So we'll just we'll overwatch like hell here. Apparently they've maybe gone a little bit away. Alright. Am I playing too careful? Oh, yeah, they're still down there. Actually, we can see him so we can throw grenades at him. I'd prefer not to, like, throw a grenade. But we'll see. Apparently they're opening doors somewhere. Now the meld is a type of resource that we can get. It can be used to kind of speed up construction of things or other kind of weird. Alright, we can't actually see him, but we can grenade him. I mean, like, that's pretty much a dead giveaway.
You may want to instruct your men to exercise restraint when using explosives. While certainly effective at killing aliens, they also destroy the artifacts we're hoping to recover from the bodies. Just something to consider.
You may want to exercise caution. Well, she's not out on the front lines. We're just gonna toss some grenades down. Okay, we didn't kill him. It doesn't look like we killed that one either. So let's throw down more grenades, shall we? I like grenades. Now, I'm too worried about, like, actually coming down here and killing that guy myself. So we're just gonna keep throwing grenades. What the f- Okay, I apparently didn't quite throw that where I thought I would. Alright, I guess we'll just overwatch the rest of these guys. Yeah, they're trying to come up the stairs now. I'm fairly certain of that now. Alright, we're gonna go on the side of this wall and we'll see if we can see him. They opted not to actually mind meld this turn. I guess I can see it, right? This is a nice position though. We're gonna continue overwatching here because they have to come after us then. It does mean, however, we won't get any meld, like, at all. Oh, there we go. We got some overwatch shots now. There we go. That kill goes to somebody. Alright. Now, with the height advantage, we don't get a defensive bonus, as I learned in my previous one. But I do get a bonus to basically aim. So I can actually probably hit him even better now. Let me go and see the person that can actually see him. Mongo Bongo, you have an abysmal hit to right there. Alright, let's bring another person over here. Oh, I didn't actually explain the AP grenades in this version yet. AP grenades, they're a new type of grenade, do one more damage than the regular grenades. But they do not, if he's in cover relative to where the blast is, you can see he's not gonna get hit anymore. When I put it, like, over here, he will. So, at this point, I'm pretty sure he's dead. This just leaves rookies to basically get, like, an easy kill. So, let's just take shots. Oh, you missed, pal. You missed again. For Christ's sake, XCOM, what are you up to? Alright, this person, we can just kind of hang out there. That's our grenader.
On the move.
Yeah, I think the grenades might potentially do one damage, so I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually chuck the AP grenade out. It's just my backup kind of an act. Holy shit. The arm on that guy. It's a game of probabilities, what can I say? Actually, I have a med kit. I could probably use it on that rookie so that rookie doesn't die. Alright. Gonna move into this right here. Yeah, you go get some healing.
Come on, time to cowboy up.
So I think he went into there. I don't know where the last sectoid there went. I guess we're gonna have to go after him. Looks like he doesn't want to play today. Do you see? Nobody needs to die. Actually, I'm gonna go reload some of these soldiers. Oh, wait, no, is he coming? Alright, yeah, we're gonna go chase after him. Not exactly what I would consider the most fun of things, but let's go do it. But we're pretty sure we heard him over there, so it gives us some clue and idea as to where he is. I'm gonna also check with the soldiers just to make sure nobody is actually down here.
That's affirmative.
Yeah, we're safe there. Alright, we're gonna keep a soldier on the high ground over here. And let's also check the rear here just to make sure nobody is waiting in our blind spot. Okay. There is actually an Overwatch all key, but it's a little bit louder. Yeah, that's where he went. That asshole. Oh, we have another group of sectoids. This is a different one. Oh, we get some reaction shots, though. Some really shit reaction shots. Also, I haven't really kept track of which rookies have gotten kills. Alright. Well, we have a couple of options here. We have some nice cover with this guy already, as it is. Question is, how far do I want to go? I don't want to move too far up, but I think what I can start doing is I can start maybe stacking up against the wall. Like, I already have nice cover here. So let's go bring this guy. I'm bringing him over to here so that we won't see the nice gentleman right away. We're just gonna try and get everybody into full cover right now. And then the one guy on this upper cover here. The high ground is still a good kind of sniper position. Now the question is, where do I move this guy? And I think the answer will be over here. The next turn he can go do something else. So if they come out here, which they might, because they... Oh, there you go. He decided to go up onto the top of the roof. We get some reaction shots, though. Oh, and that was a kill. There you go. Kind of just wait for him to show up and not run needlessly in and get rookies killed. I mean, who the fuck does that? Alright, we got another one. It's unfortunate I don't have actual regular grenades, because those would be very effective at dealing with sectoids. Alright. Now we have a couple of options here. We can kind of like goad him into kind of coming out of there, because only one of my people sees him. So let's do that. Nobody else sees him. He has to come out. He doesn't know what to expect here, so it's an ambush. I think some of my guys should come over here, but just in case they start heading out that window. Apparently they can see this guy, which is odd. We'll dash him over here now. Oh, wait. We have an Overwatch. And... okay. That guy is completely out of cover there, which makes it a really easy shot for one of my... whenever there's someone that's not in cover, it's a really easy shot for someone to do something. So there you go, 65%. Unfortunately, that was a miss. Wah, 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 wah. Alright.
Okay.
It's worth it to try and get that guy. Because next turn, he'll try and move back into cover. I remember, I'm sticking to the full cover here. Low cover isn't as useless as it was in some of the original, in the vanilla XCOM, but it's still worthwhile to basically be very careful. I don't want to move him over here because there could be something I don't see yet. But we can move over here just to bring that grenade to bear. He's still got a grenade there, and I might be grenading him. Alright, it's only one guy. And, well, never mind. One guy just became four. He did not... he decided to apparently run headlong at XCOM here. Not the wisest of choices, my sectoid friend. Alright. That guy is probably completely unaware of the fact that we have a shot here. Even though this guy is overwatching, I don't think he'll have a shot on this guy. No, he won't. And that makes him the kill. No! But what if Sectoid was not killed? Alright. We got problems now. Alright. We're gonna bring a team into here. Unfortunately, he's overwatching for his friend there. But if I go here, I'll be okay. We can actually get a grenade in there. It will probably not kill him, but it's at the very least something.
Grenade out.
I would like to get that flank. There we go. Okay, we got rid of the Overwatch threat. So we can now try and get this guy once again. Let's see, Mongo Bongo, can you take the 65%? Oh, well, you did good. But not good enough. I might be able to get a grenade over there. Because I would like to kill him before he becomes a threat. Well, I can also shoot him, but grenade. Now, this is not the best cover. I now have this person in half cover, although there's full cover there. I'm not sure quite what XCOM does with that. But we got him. That's the main thing. I got rid of a threat, which I think was the more important part. And I'm going to move people to Overwatch there. As one of our sectoid friends comes over there. There we go. Alright. We have one more. Now, I think this is the last guy. So, we can either just chuck shit at him or do something else. We got two grenades to bring on him. Yeah, we'll take some shots at him. I'm pretty sure this is the last gentleman. Ugh. I'm gonna move this guy. I'm gonna sprint him up here. And next turn he'll drop down on him. I would also like to move this person up here.
Rolling out.
So, if we overwatch him, he shouldn't move, basically.
Bien.
And this will be my reload. So, he should be just kind of petrified. Okay, he's overwatching. Alright. What if we overwatch again? Oh, he takes a shot. Alright, now my troopers up there got it. Cue the Starship Troopers theme. The apes want to live forever. Hello. Have you heard? I like guns. There we go.
If I may, Commander, the labs are on high alert. Teams are standing by for your orders. We can begin researching the newly recovered artifacts immediately.
Alright, let's go see how much the game has fucked me with Steam Vent placement. This is my favorite time of starting every fucking new game.
Commander to the research labs. Commander to the research labs.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, Commander. I'm Central Officer Bradford. My role in this project is twofold. Providing tactical support for our field operations, and keeping you briefed on the current situation. My efforts should allow you to focus on the bigger issues at hand. Speaking of which, we have a soldier waiting for a promotion in the barracks. I'll let you get to it.
Oh man, we got some promotions to give out now. Let's go see actually how we did in terms of kills, if it's actually like distributed. Because to me that's completely random. Oh shit, look. Oh, everyone except for Halidin got kills. What were you doing, Halidin? But everyone got a promotion anyways. So Mungabung got wounded, we healed him, but it didn't matter, so. We have a lot of promotions here. So in Long War, there's more classes now. Two more classes,
Commander,
mostly that Gunner and Rocketeer
Commander
have been split.
The
Assault class serves as our front line. They're the first ones into a fight, and the last ones out.
So we can either make this person a Shotgunner, Rod and Gun, or an Infantry Light Him Up. We're gonna make an Infantry just because I've learned from a stream, basically, to love the Infantry.
Our snipers specialize in dealing massive amounts of damage from afar. But without sufficient training, they're vulnerable in close combat situations.
We have Scout with Lightning Reflexes, which you can build it in a numerous amount of ways. Or you have Squad Sight, which is basically making it into a sniper right away. If you remember from vanilla XCOM, Squad Sight was always one of those abilities for snipers. Like, snipers are useless without it. In this one, it's actually something you get as your first ability. It's actually makes sense, and it's really, really nice.
Just like it sounds, the support class provides that intangible edge our squads need. They make everyone around them better.
We have Grenader, which can... They have two destructive grenades per slot, so you can have like four HE grenades or something per mission. Or you can have a field medic, which gives a free, three medkits basically, so we're gonna get that. In this mod, I'm not really sold on grenaders, I'm sorry, I don't really like them.
The heavy weapons specialist provides a crucial service to the squad. With the rocket launcher in tow, there are demolitions experts.
We either have Gunner, which is for suppression, so you get the LMG, or you get Rocketeer, which you get a rocket. Well, it's basically rockets. So this is one of the splits in the classes. We have another one here, and we'll make this one a Rocketeer. Rocketeers are very inaccurate. They can really either really be really good or be very bad, depending upon your luck, which I don't like. And then we'll now have an assault now. So we have a good variation in abilities there. We just are lacking, I think, a scout and a grenade.
The recovered artifacts are being unloaded, and the research team is waiting your orders. We'll get started as soon as you give the order, Commander.
Alright, we got research to do.
Hello, Commander. My name is Dr. Farlan. I oversee the research labs. This is where all of XCOM's research and development takes place. We have already begun analyzing the artifacts recovered from our first encounter with the aliens. Based on our preliminary findings, we believe we can use them to develop some new equipment for our soldiers. With your approval, we will begin research immediately.
All right, we got some new research
Commander
to do.
To engineering. Commander to engineering.
Apparently we can do alien materials, but we're doing alien weaponry first. Because we need it.
I realize our troops have to put their own survival first, but every alien we use explosives against is one less opportunity to recover new artifacts.
Shut up, Valen.
Ah, Commander. I was wondering when you'd be stopping by. Welcome to engineering. Anything they can dream up in the research labs, we can build it here. Speaking of which, Dr. Valen has just sent us some new schematics. With your approval, we will begin fabrication.
I should mention, I'm a complete fucking addict for this game.
We've still got some room to grow up here, but if we really want to expand our facilities, we're going to have to start excavating beneath the base. Unfortunately, The deeper we go, the more it's going to cost.
I don't really like the steam vent being there, but it looks like I don't really have a choice in this matter. Because this is right where I'd have, like, my satellite block. My satellite, like, block. So maybe I'll just go for that one right here.
Commander to mission control.
And then we'll skip this one.
Commander to mission control.
Commander to mission control. Alright. We have some, well, actually, let's just do mission control first.
The council is going to want satellite coverage, so we should plan our deployments carefully.
Alright, and so if we press launch.
Facilities at maximum capacity.
Yeah, there you go. Basically, in Long War, the panic system has changed. It's now based upon an actual
Commander
bar graph.
Control.
Rather than it being just about, like, a flat amount. Like just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, it's like 3 and a little bit. And now it's actually quite nice. And also, you get a bit of money even from countries you don't have satellites over. They all give you just a random amount of money, which is very nice. So satellites isn't that important to rush now. And here's our globe spinny thing, but we're not doing that quite yet. We have some items to make. We get some sawed-off shotguns, so we'll make like about 5 of those. You have to actually make these, and they're absolutely free, so you can make like as many as you want. Just gonna make 5, I never use more than that. We also have shivs right off the fucking bat. No joke. That's really quite the best thing ever. We also have satellites to make, I think.
Our current satellite uplink facilities are at full capacity. We should build additional uplinks as soon as possible to allow for new satellite deployments.
We can now build quickly these, but it makes it like 420 smokums and 10 meld to build in half the time, but we don't need, we're good on time, so we're just gonna make it in half the time, in the normal time. And we can also make, we're gonna start our first shiv here. So yeah, we get shivs right off the bat. They are very valuable, very, very nice to have. So there's that. We also wanna go make our first satellite uplink real soon, but we don't have enough funds for that, so we're gonna wait until we do maybe another mission or something to get that out of the way. And I guess we're pretty much good for that. And oh yes, we have aircraft now. And aircraft.
Selecting a specific jet within the hangar, you can choose to modify its current weapon loadout to best serve our needs.
It's basically either Stingray missiles or Avalanche missiles, and the difference is one of them has armor penetration. So we'll make one of them have armor penetration. That sounds fine. We also renamed the ships, but I can't actually choose their names. It just picks from a random pool, so we can have Mustang Bay something, Sandman Murray, Time Zone Zhao. That's kind of nice, but no. Slapshot. I like that name. Okay, that's a good one. We're just gonna pick the random names. Jeter? No. Moose? No. Paco? Paco! Okay, Paco can be there. Slash? No. Goodnight? No. Meat Hook? I like the nicknames. Ace? No. Not so Sharpe. Okay. Painter? No. Furball? Yeah, that sounds pretty good. Actually, no, that doesn't. So fuck that. Mongoose? No. Jammer? No. Painter? Tally? Jeter? Candyman? Furball? What the fuck? All these suck. Oh, there we go. We got 6-pack again. Our favorite man. Leroy? Maybe we should have kept that one. But it just randomizes some name. Zeke? Tex? Quick Draw? Freebird? Lunchbox Turnbill? I like that guy. Also, interceptors are super fucking expensive, so yeah. We have to be careful because the air game in this mod is fucking huge. It's ridiculous.
Several members of the council have expressed an interest in acquiring some of the artifacts we've recovered. However, we should be careful in choosing what items we release. The research team may not have discovered their true value yet.
Alright. Well, I guess we'll go see the soldiers that we have, because they all have various names from our names file, so we'll actually see if there's, I'll point out people that are familiar, at least to me, but you can see if you're near. We got PFC Rip, he's there. Let me scroll down a page. Don't recognize these guys. Also, if you ever get a nickname, I get to choose your nickname, and it gets to be awful. Libby's here. Alpha Tig. I recognize some of these guys. Tivez. Just telling you people, I just did. I recognize a lot of these people from the streams and stuff. Triple Strike is here. I remember him bitching about how he was never made it into any of these. Oh, we have Darwal naturally, and I think that's pretty much it. So there you go. And the Mike. We definitely got to bring him on the next mission. Generally speaking, you're probably going to die in a horrible fashion. Or maybe not, who knows. Libby's here. We all love Libby. So, we're gonna bring along a nice team of rookies for the next mission. Well, not all rookies, maybe, but a lot of rookies. So we're gonna spin the globe now. Our sawed-off shotguns are complete. As I said, they don't cost anything and take like a day to make, and they're easy. Oh, we already have abductions.
Commander, we've picked up multiple requests for assistance. Abductions in progress are marked on the hologlobe.
I'm not starting it now, but I'll explain a little mechanic for you guys. There's a fatigue system in this game, so 2 days, 3 days, 3 days, 2 days, 3 days. Basically, they get tired after a mission. I can bring them along, but the problem is, if I bring them along, they're basically gonna become tired for double the amount of days that you see here, so then I can't use them. So it's in case of emergency kind of a situation. That's just the mechanic. It's not as important in the Not-So-Long War second wave option, but still important all the less, because look, I just had another mission here, and I can't... If I bring one of these people along, they're going to be out for basically a day or something, so... That's how that goes. But anyways, I'll explain some of the weapons and stuff in the next episode, so I hope you're enjoying, and remember, we'll be watching.